Hello, Mountain View Church. It has been a crazy week, has it not? With the closures and stock market reversals, it's a time that could be pretty ripe for panic, and we're seeing some of that. But I think it's also a time that could be unique in us growing to trust God and also to project that hope to others around us who are maybe listening in a different way. In the New Testament, there's some classic go-to verses that speak to fear and anxiety, like Philippians 4:6. But a verse that came to my mind is from John 16. It's Jesus' last and his longest teaching to his disciples before he went to the cross. And in it, he's preparing them for all the challenges that are going to lie ahead of them. In verse 33, Jesus says, "In this world, you will face troubles, guaranteed. But take heart, I have overcome the world." And if you look into the history of the early church, you can see that though the disciples faced some incredible challenges at times, they also seemed to do so out of a place of strength, knowing that King Jesus had already won the biggest victory over their sin and over death. And so in these next weeks, we're going to have some unique opportunities to show the peace and strength that the victory of Jesus has for us with other people, especially in those small circles of coworkers and friends and neighbors that we can still gather with. Also, in these next weeks, we're going to have some time and opportunity to grow deeper in our prayer rhythm of taking and turning over every fear and anxiety to God when they pop up in front of us. And lastly, in these next weeks, we're going to have chances and maybe more downtime with the cancellations that we could binge on Netflix, and that's something, but we could also redeem the time by taking it and reading and reflecting on the biblical account of how God has always provided for his people, which will help us from becoming prisoners of the moment and be reminded that God has and always will be on the throne. And for that, we can truly praise him. So in the next week, we'll keep you updated on ways that we'll creatively keep connected. And so we'll let you know what those things are. And then on Sunday, look for our Sunday sermon at 9 o'clock that will be posted on the MVC website and also on a mass email link. So goodbye for now, and blessings to you as you live and do the gospel in this time.